because he wants to meet with you. He wants to talk to you. So when the appointed time came, all that the prophet Moses did was, he would just get up early in the morning, go up to the mountain, because they have a special meeting place. And he stands there and he tells God, "Here I am, Lord. I have come to present myself before you." That's all. Your job is to present yourself. And then God will come and talk with you. Present yourself waiting on him. This is the greatest lack in the church today. If you want to hear God, if you want to move in the prophetic anointing, you must learn to put away every distraction and shut yourself in and wait on God. That's why I always tell, shut your phones. Why do you don't even put it in silence mode? Shut it off. You have come to hear the voice of God talking to you. So why allow the phone to ring? You know, when we do youth camp meetings in India, the one condition I put before all the youths is, if you want to come to my meeting, no cell phones allowed for the complete 5 days of the camp meeting. You are not allowed to use a cell phone. If on any emergency, I will give you the number of the camp commandant. Your parents can call the camp commandant and pass a message, period. You are not allowed to use your mobile phones for 5 complete days. If you agree to this condition, you can come. If you cannot live without your cell phones, then don't come to my meeting. There are so many other youth meetings around the whole world, you can go there. And when the youths come to our meetings, they never leave without an encounter with God. Because when you put away all distractions, you have nothing else, only God and you. No TVs, no internet, no cell phones, no nothing. You are like living with the Flintstones. You know the Flintstones. But even the Flintstones had the TVs, you know. But so we'll go before the Flintstone age, Stone age. You know, that is the reason why the prophets were always living in secluded place, away from the maddening crowd, away from human dwellings and entanglements. Last night, the Lord spoke to me something about the life of a prophet. Why a prophet should not entangle himself in the affairs of men? Because when you pray, you know, when you are so involved with another person, okay, or not yesterday, this morning, I was praying about a pastor, a certain pastor. He called me early this morning with a serious problem in their family. So after just encouraging him, I was just praying for him, praying about his family situation, praying for him. Then the Lord spoke to me, why this thing happened in his family? Then I told the Lord, but you know, this other things happened in his family, and some other prophetic people had given him prophetic words which were contrary to what you told me from the beginning. So how is it, it can be contrary, Lord? Because those people were also sincere prophetic people. Then the Lord told me, he said, this is the reason why I always told all my prophets, now this is going to biblical days, to stay away from entanglement with society. Why? Because when, let's say for example, you have 2 good friends and you share all your burdens, all your problems to that person, and then you say, can you please pray and give me a word? See, the person with whom you're sharing, that person now becomes emotionally connected with you. When they become emotionally connected, your emotions will now get mixed with your spirit and hearing from God. They get